It's terrific. Let's say hi to Joe Rogan. Joe.
Yo, what's up, guys?
Here he is.
Hey, aren't you coming in to do our show Friday?
Yes, I'm coming in on Friday, man. I'm excited. I'm hoping I won't swear, though.
Yeah, that's kind of the tightrope we've been walking here for the past, well, how long have we been on? About an hour?
I mean, I'm so happy for you guys. It's really phenomenal. I'm just, it just sucks that I can't, you can't go off. But we will be able to go off between 9 and 11. Is that how it goes?
Yeah. We're basically doing two radio shows a day now.
That's phenomenal.
So.
Yeah, you're not much of a potty mouth, though, Joe.
I know. I try to keep it clean.
Joe is the worst. Joe is the worst.
Yeah, I really have a problem.
Are you still shooting your television program?
No, the television program is probably officially done. It's it airs again June, July, and August, but most of it's pretty much done.
How many years has that been on?
Six.
Jesus. Wow, what happened?
It's enough, you know? I think it's just ran its course. You know, the ratings are terrible this year.
Really?
Yeah, you know, people get tired of it, and I really don't want to do it anymore. I just want to do stand-up. If they keep giving me money, I'll keep doing it, you know, because it's too much money to pass up on, but I don't really want to do it anymore. I haven't wanted to do it for years.
I think the internet ruined it, too. The internet ruins everything.
The internet ruined it?
Yeah, you just go to the internet, you see whatever you want. It's like, oh, somebody eating something weird or, you know, doing some kind of weird stunt. Eh.
Yeah, well, there's definitely more exciting things. They did a good job of, like, keeping it fresh and everything, but at the end of the day, it's just a stupid game show. And
didn't you guys stop eating stuff?
No, they did it less. You know, they're always, like, trying to dance around the advertisers. The advertisers would get mad if we, like, we fed them a horse rectum once, and, like, we lost, like, 50 advertisers, Budweiser, all these people pulled out,
ugh,
you know, because they were just disgusted. So we tried to do less of that, but
yeah.
Well, if you want to, you should. There's a fine horse video on the internet that I can think of where a gentleman died.
See, that's what I'm thinking.
Yeah,
but people rather tune into that.
But that video wasn't sponsored by anybody. That's,
nope.
I think that's the point Joe's making.
It should have been sponsored by.
That video is removed from my website. I don't know what you guys are talking about.
It should have been sponsored by Budweiser. It was like a Clydesdale. Like play some Christmas music and watch that guy's intestines be loosened. Fantastic.
I'm gonna interview Gangsta Fag.
Oh, really?
Are you?
Yeah, I'm supposed to meet that guy. I'm terrified, though, because he's like 6'4", 240 pounds. Mm. He's huge. He's a big, giant homo.
Very scary.
This is the dilemma we have going back to terrestrial radio. Do we do the Gangsta Fag over here, or do we do it over there?
Little of both.
Well, the songs are really dirty now that I think about it.
Yeah.
It's pretty hard, even content-wise, to get away with the stuff he's talking about.
I think it'd be actually funny to play it on terrestrial and just have, like, beat, and I'm on, and then just, like, it gets beeps for 30 seconds, and then beat.
Run from the beep.
Yeah, he's a very scary guy.
Someone sold me out with him.
Oh, we haven't talked to Joe Rogan about this.
Yeah, he's got a MySpace account.
Gangsta Fag does?
Yeah.
Yeah?
And
for the newbies, it's a guy that does hardcore rap, but he happens to be a gay guy. A gay black gentleman.
He's a big black gay guy that does gangster rap.
And brags about banging dudes.
Yeah, instead of talking about, like, broads, he talks about guys.
It's hilarious.
And somebody had a fake MySpace account under my name and messaged Gangsta Fag that I wanted to hook up with him. And he wrote this very apologetic letter that he didn't want to be with me.
Oh,
I was
hilarious.
Insulted, kind of.
Like, I appreciate you playing my music, but I'm, no.
Yeah, I was kind of insulted.
Not even for plugs.
No.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Were you kind of bummed, Anthony, just a little bit? Not because you're gay, but that you got rejected.
Choosy fag.
You got rejected by a guy who rapes other guys in jail. Who
I know.
Went, no, I'd prefer not to.
Yeah. Right, it would pretty much do anything.
Yeah, he's rapping about, like, one of his songs, I guess some southern skinheads beat up one of his friends. And he goes to the bar that the southern skinheads are hanging out at, waits at the back door, beats him over the head with baseball bats, and then proceeds to have their way with these hillbillies. And he won't do me. I just...
You gotta admit, it hurts a little.
You know...
It hurts a little.
I was a little put off.
A little bummed out.
You know what it is? You're slender, and I bet he tends to like a fatter-bottomed boy.
Do you think that's it?
Yeah.
He might just have a type, you know? You never know.
You know something? Truthfully, I was so happy.
You were relieved.
Oh, my God, was I relieved. Because who knows? If he's a big guy, and you're going to say no, if he grabs you somewhere, you know, maybe you're going into the restroom, and he decides he wants to have his way with you, what are you going to say? Excuse me, huge gentleman. Down, Kong.
No.
What are you gonna, you're not going to say anything.
Here's what you're going to say.
Yeah, I can't wait to meet this dude. It's going to be quite interesting. But I'm bringing a couple people with me. I'm not going solo.
Well, here. Joe, we all know you know how to kick ass.
Yeah, well, you know what? The size matters. That's a big dude.
Yeah, I think you put him down, though, with some of your martial arts. I've seen you on the Ultimate Fighting. You sound like you know what you're talking about.
Sound like I know what I'm talking about. There's a big difference between that and being able to take out a gigantic homo.
When was the last time you beat the crap out of someone?
You mean in the gym or?
No, I mean just like somebody giving you a little crap and you.
Oh, it's been a long time since like high school.
Really?
Yeah.
I see, no one screws with you though. That's what it is. Like they kind of know you well enough to know to leave you alone.
Sometimes people do. You know what? I'm pretty good at avoiding stuff. And, you know, if people can say whatever they want. As long as they're not going to cause me to fight. Oh, the only way I would fight is if I was really worried that my health was in danger or somebody I knew was in danger.
Yeah. His reputation.
Sometimes you can get out of there before it gets ugly.
Rogan's also the funny guy, which is weird. Like, I always had to be the funny guy because I wasn't the big guy. So I never got my ass beat in school or anything because I was always like, everybody kind of liked me. I was funny in school.
Well, that explains Rogan's why pole. I got my ass kicked in high school a lot.
Really?
I became funny for a different reason. I became funny because I used to fight a lot in these martial arts tournaments and boxing tournaments. And we used to go travel together in these trips and everybody would be nervous. It was like gallows humor. So I would just crack everybody up to kind of lighten up the mood because everybody was like really nervous. We were going to fight in these full contact tournaments and some of us would get knocked out and stuff. It was pretty great.
Would you travel with the people you would actually fight?
No. I travel with the team that I was on.
That's a little awkward.
Yeah.
Kick someone's ass and they're sitting right next to you. Hey, how's that arm?
Guys in a neck brace. Hey, sorry about that whole you'll never walk again thing.
No, you know, just travel with the guys that I used to work out with. And they're the ones who actually talked me into doing stand-up in the first place.
I got to tell you, I saw Joe Rogan in L.A. a bunch of times. His stand-up is unbelievable.
Yeah, it kills.
If I didn't know me, I would think I probably sucked.
No, you're a thinking man.
If you saw me on TV and you're like, you know, you saw Fear Factor, you're like, how is that ass clown funny?
No, you're a thinking man's comedian, and it's obvious that you smoke a lot of pot.
Yeah.
It was obvious on the show. Hey, did you have a wind of the show not being picked up on the last season?
Well, you mean what? Did I look more high last season?
You kind of looked more high, and you looked like you really could care less.
I really could care less. I started getting high season two. If you watch like the repeats, look like season one is like he looks normal. Season two, it like looks normal till about episode 12, and I was like, all right, screw this.
Yeah, you would like really interview the people and get into their persona and stuff before they would do the stunts. And then last season, I was watching like there'd be some chick, and she's got to jump off of this raft that's being pulled by a speedboat, and she'd do it, and she'd come back, and you'd just be like, hey, that was something, huh? Like, no info.
Last time I saw Rogan, he's standing at the Comedy Store just licking a pot lollipop while some 65-year-old woman fawned over him.
Dream come true.
Mom. That's Pauly Shore's best friend's mom.
Oh, it was hilarious.
That was bizarre. How about that girl that I was with? We were sitting there talking, and me and Jim are having this conversation about quantum physics. We're talking about, what is that guy's name? Professor Haku? Is that his name?
Michio Kaku. He actually lives in my building, yeah.
We're talking about him. We're talking about, like, quantum theory and all this crazy stuff. And this chick I'm with goes, I like waffles.
Oh, great.
Absolutely true. She was a 10.
I've seen out of a movie.
And you turned and laughed and gave her all the attention she needed.
No, waffles are good. Yeah, you just grovel.
Because she's pretty. An ugly chick, you'd have told her, shut up.
Yeah, fat chick, of course, you'd say, well, of course you like waffles, pig. Two men are talking.
Yeah, it was a classic moment.
Let's demonstrate gravity with your fat ass.
Well, Joe, we're going to see you on Friday.
Yes, I'm very much looking forward to coming back. I'm doing the Borgata in Atlantic City on Friday night. So I'm coming in to just hang out with you guys. That's the only reason I'm coming to New York.
Are you doing what are you doing, the music box?
Yeah.
Cool, man. Do you got ticket info? Like how to get I know the Borgata.com Because I'm actually doing it with Hotel in May. So if you want to go to theborgata.com if you want tickets for that.
Yes, that's it.
All right, Joe, we'll see
guys,
you on Friday.
Thank you very much. I'll see you Friday.
Bye, that's sweetie. Right.
Thanks for calling us on our first day. We appreciate
Congratulations,
it.
Congratulations, man. You guys deserve everything you're getting. This is fantastic.
Thanks, Joe.
Awesome.
Joe,
see you Friday.
All right, Joe. Let's see.